you will learn what happened in that 9 minutes and 29 seconds. The most important numbers you will hear in this trial are 929. May 25th of 2020, Mr. Derek Chauvin betrayed this badge when he used excessive and unreasonable force upon the body of Mr. George Floyd.
Derek Chauvin's defense in the death of George Floyd has taken quite the turn, and it could be enough to guarantee Chauvin's freedom. Welcome into TYT Overruled. I'm attorney and legal analyst Adrienne Lawrence. The murder trial of former Minneapolis police officer Derek Chauvin started on Monday, with his attorneys giving us a hint of what his expected defense will be. And it appears that Chauvin's blaming bystanders for Floyd's death. They're claiming that Chauvin did exactly as he was trained to do when he knelt on the neck of the 46-year-old George Floyd, but that bystanders were distracting the police officers such that they became concerned for their own safety and couldn't focus on Floyd. Now, Chauvin is evidently trying to depict these bystanders as a mob. Does this look like a mob to you?
Hey now, bro, you know it's bogus. You can't even look at me like a man because you're a bum, bro. He's not even resisting arrest right now, bro.
He passed out.
That's what happens on the ground.
He's breathing right now, bro. You think that's cool?
That's what happened.
You think that's cool, though, right? What's your badge number, bro? You think that's cool right now, bro?
Yeah, me neither. But Chauvin's argument is that the mob distracted him from Floyd's pleas, suggesting that the officers fear for their own safety, as though they would possibly be rushed by this mob, despite the fact that they are a fully armed brigade of officers. And in that group of people were children, and we heard them testify on Tuesday. Now, among them was a 9-year-old who said he knew Floyd's life was in danger. He even pleaded to Chauvin to get off of Floyd's neck and to check to see if he was alive. The child also testified that paramedics asked Chauvin nicely to get off of Floyd's neck, but he stayed on it, that Chauvin had to be pushed off of the neck of Floyd. Now, the credibility of these witnesses and their testimony is going to be important here to the jury's decision, but it won't necessarily be essential because we have camera footage. Still, prosecutors are pushing these witnesses to recount their stories and experiences because adding that emotional, humanized element that we can't get from a video camera, well, it helps the jury to put themselves in the position of someone who was there. Not just so that they see the circumstances through the lens of the officers, but they see the circumstances through those who are around, and they can be the ones to determine, was it reasonable how Chauvin responded and his whole defense of fearing this mob or not being able to hear Floyd's pleas to get off of his neck. Basically, what the prosecutors here are trying to convey is that if ordinary average people and even children knew that Floyd's life was in danger, why didn't Chauvin and the rest of the officers know? That's a hell of a question, and we may get answers over the next few days. So as the trial unfolds, we'll bring you more legal analysis here. In the meantime, please follow us for more, and thanks for watching.